Hey guys, welcome back to 5 Live. We switched roles a little bit. We got Scott here now at the desk because we're talking about something both of us love.
And that would be sneakers.
Sneakers. And we're here
Fly sneakers.
With Eli Hayman. He's from Wype The Hype. It's on Melrose, and it's not a sneaker store. It's a place where you can get your already dirty sneakers clean again. Yes. Eli, thanks for joining
us. Yeah, thanks for being here.
How are you guys doing?
Nice good.
To see you. So we need to know how you decided, hey, this needs to be a thing. It's basically like a sneaker dry cleaner.
Yeah, so basically when I was younger, I've always been in love with sneakers since I was like a young child. I resold a little, you know, a little bit of that. I dabbled. And basically I was always helping my friends like clean their sneakers because like I just like, I learned because it would help like the resale value, and then also I just like to keep my shoes nice and clean. And I was always doing it for my friends, and I live in like the La Brea area, which is right next to like Melrose, like the sneaker hub central of and culture and everything. So I felt like it needed to be done. Like I felt like there were a lot of older people and people our age that like would always tell me like that they just wish it was an area. So I felt like...
I like how you said older people and people our age were actually the older people.
I feel like when he said older people, he kind of was like, should I look at them? I shouldn't, but that's who I mean.
Well, no, like my clientele ranges from like anywhere between like 12 to... I've had some 60-year-olds, you know.
The hype 12-year-old that's like, I'm going to go get these shoes?
A lot of like little kids that like get like $1,000 pair of shoes, and they got a crazy deal, as they call them, steals, and they paid like me $400, and so they pay $30, $40 to get them cleaned, and then they're wearing like some $600-$700 shoes on their feet. So
you have some shoes that you're going to clean for us, but before we get there, just tell everyone who doesn't know what it means to kind of be a sneakerhead, or when you're saying like you did some resale, what is that? Explain to people kind of what that culture is and like kind of why people care so much about their shoes.
Well, firstly, everyone just like gravitates towards something, you know. There's car lovers, there's stamp lovers, there's coin lovers, you know, and it's just kind of like what you like and how you feel and how the shoes make you feel. Like when I was younger, I just always cared about fashion and about shoes, and just like a lot of people, like sometimes they find their clothing and then their shoes. A true sneakerhead, they start from the ground. Ground up. Like their shoes are their centerpiece.
I have to figure out what goes with the shoe, not what shoe goes with the outfit. Yeah. It starts from, okay, are they black and red Jordans? Okay, then I need black jeans and I need some accent color. Like,
so maybe white,
so
you know,
true.
Some like a subtle white, you know, but like the core is supposed to be your sneakers.
So here's,
I didn't know I was one until you just told me.
Well, so here's my thing. When I was probably, I don't know, 11 or 12, the shoe I wanted so much was the Air Penny, the one that had the air bubble in the back, the white, blue, and silver one.
Are you thinking yourself?
No, just because like they were the coolest sneaker. I thought they were so amazing. So what shoe, when you were kind of getting started, what was your, you were like, that was my shoe, I fell in love from that moment. Because those were mine, because I spent $120.
I mean, mine are a little more expensive.
That's like, fine. to be expected.
I still want it. I still haven't got them because they're like, they resell for like $2,000.
Oh, the dream
shoe? It's not a dream shoe. I have a bunch of shoes that I like. Like I have a lot of wants, obviously, which is bad, but they're like $2,000. They resell. They're called the Yeezy Turtle Doves. They're by Kanye and stuff like that, and I just really like them, and I just haven't gone around to buying them. I've been waiting for my size. I have small feet. I have 7, so like it's hard to find.
If you have them out there,
reach out.
Come on.
7364 Melrose Avenue. I'm there every day.
But here's my question. What about when you were a kid, though? What was like your favorite when you were like...
Well, I mean, that's been around for like 4 or 5 years.
Oh my God, is he that young? All right.
We do have to say, you are still in school. You're at USC.
Yeah.
And you own a business.
Yeah. I'm only taking one course in this next semester, but I do want to graduate.
That's all right, fair enough. Yeah. So he's young enough that these 4 or 5 years ago, he's like, well, I was pretty much a kid then. All right. So
okay. No, but like when I was younger, I mean, I guess I gravitated towards Jordan 1s. Like,
yeah.
Just like, you know, they're so iconic.
Right.
The shoe, like the silhouette, like I remember when I was younger, I just always like looked at them and like thought they were so cool. I remember my coach when I was in like 3rd grade had them, and he would always wear Jordans, and he always looked so cool, and they were like $400 really cool Air Jordans, and I was thinking like I didn't know much about shoes when I was younger,
right?
But when I started to learn about them, I was just like, okay, and now I have like a bunch of Jordans.
Yeah, well, cool story is you told us before this that you used to walk to this sneaker store that is now your storefront.
Yeah, so they actually had like the first Kanye West shoe at that store, like the first ever Nike like shoe that they sold was at that location. They had a bunch of Jordans that I loved. You know, I would always go to them, and my parents like didn't want to pay for them, obviously, because you
parents just don't understand.
They're like, two shoes is enough. Is that like, you don't need more than one. So yeah.
Okay.
So if I have a huge sneaker collection. I think I have like maybe 45 pairs of Jordans, okay. And I wear them in rotation. So not all of them get dirty, but some of them I have like staples. Like there's five out that I always wear, and I use the wipes, but they never really get cleaned. So mm-hmm. I'm like, all right, I'm taking them to Wype the Hype. What's the process?
So firstly, we use for every shoe is different. We treat every shoe differently. These are a more simple shoe. They'll clean up nicer and quicker. But generally, like if you bring in, for example, suede shoes, we never use water. Like because the second you kind of use the water on the suede, it'll kind of mess it up. If there's suede on the shoe and then we have other things, we'll use like maybe like a small toothbrush to get around it. But usually we kind of use the same like three brushes, a soft brush for the uppers, a medium brush for the midsoles, which this part's the midsoles. Uh-huh. And then a lot of the customers, sneakerheads are very particular about the shoes. Every little detail matters to them. They want their bottoms cleaned. I know it might sound crazy, but like,
because you're walking on
but still, that's something that's important to them. So this is the hardest brush for the bottoms. So there's a brush kind of for everything. But like also like with mesh material, like Flyknit and other type of materials that are like white and shoes.
Yeah, actually, I'm going to get Scott's shoes mm-hmm. that are
yeah.
here.
Oh, yeah. That's
and
a good.
And I've been warned that they stink.
They might be a little smelly.
This material is way different. Like they're making shoes out of a lot of different textures. Mm-hmm. So how do you know which ones use on which if it's a newer shoe?
Firstly, like you can use water solution on this one as well. The trick to cleaning your shoes,
They're not that bad. They might be.
The trick to cleaning these shoes is just time. Like actually, like a lot of people, they have the same exact products as me. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, they'll go over it for 3 minutes and they'll do a rush job and it won't look good. But the thing is with me, I'll go and I'll clean them for like 20, 30, 40, like an hour and a half for some shoes. Like it really depends, every shoe is different. And then I'll put them back in and I'll be like, oh, those are still dirty. So that's why we have a standard 3 days to be able to actually look at them.
Are you doing the physical cleaning yourself?
Right now.
Someone will spend 30 yeah. minutes.
No. Right now, I'm very new. So, you know what I mean? Like, it's hard to run a business
yeah.
and it's expensive to run a business. So often nights I'm there to like 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, so
I've been there to 6 a.m. cleaning shoes.
Wow.
And then my store opens up at 11 and then I get dinner right after work and I go back to the store and clean. Like I have a friend, she comes with me every night and she helps me just out of the kindness of her heart. So first, yes, it's tough.
Wow.
Let's just talk about how cool these are, mm-hmm. no matter
they're
what.
Beautiful.
They're very nice. It's cool. But
it's
you you brought in some very dirty shoes that mm-hmm. you said you just took them outside, got them all mucked up, mm-hmm. which I assume most people's shoes aren't that dirty, but
we said maybe festivals.
Back from Coachella.
You know, people came back like from Coachella and they were just like beat, and you know, like it depends.
So let's start the process. Kind of walk us through what you do as you do it.
So the first thing I do, I get my apron. So
I got an apron too.
Yep.
Okay. We're going to
apron.
We're
going to keep the sweater clean. I'm not touching the shoes though, so we're good. I don't need an apron.
Okay. Gotta keep. You gotta
you
get
like
ready.
Me tie you in here, Scott?
No, it's okay. I'm gonna leave it to the
are
professionals.
Are you sure? I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
It's just too cute on you. So fresh.
They're really small.
It's like, yeah.
Okay.
All right. Darling.
Good.
So now that we have this ready.
Right, because you're wearing a very nice shirt. You don't want to mess that up. I'm assuming.
I mess it up all the time, but it happens.
Okay.
Okay. We take our solution, pour it in the bowl of water.
Now, is this like something you're allowed to tell us what's in there?
There's like different chemicals like jojoba oil and water and a few other things. It's complicated.
Okay. All right.
We deal with our distributors and they do it. So.
All right.
Okay. So the first step that we do, I pre-took out the laces. You dip the laces in the solution. This is how I usually clean my laces. Just like, it's kind of pretty simple. You know?
Yeah.
I usually like wash it out with the water after and it'll come out cleaner because the dirt the problem is like the dirt, like when you wash it out, all the dirt will come out. But
usually, I see.
I'll just do this.
Because that is one of the things I've tended to notice is that it's not only the laces that get dirt, the laces get dirty, and then the area around the laces, and you might be able to clean that.
I was going
to
say, or you don't take them out, and you're like, the shoe's clean, but the laces are dirty.
So every time I clean a pair of shoes, it doesn't matter, I always take out the laces, just because like you have to get the entire
uppers.
You
have far more attention to detail than we do.
So that's also another thing, like, you know, a lot of people say, why go to the dry cleaner when I can do it? It in theory you can do it, but the thing is like no one's gonna put in more effort than me.
I actually believe that 100%.
Like I put my like dedication to literally every shoe. So okay, we're gonna put these to the side, and I'll okay. So what I usually start off with is we already put a shoe tree in. The shoe tree is to keep the form of the shoe, so that when we're scrubbing down, it's
pop it out just so people can see what it looks like.
Just the different.
Okay, so this is like when you go to a lot of times when it's on the sneakers or on the wall, these are in there to kind of make it look. So you try to keep the form.
Yeah, it also keeps the form. So after I'm finished with any shoe, what I will do is I will make like a paper shoe tree, put them in. Because it also looks better when you present them, when you take them out of the bag. We have special custom like print bags, and then we take them out of the bags inside the bag. And like it has a nicer shape to it, and it looks cleaner, and it looks.
So it's
good.
Almost like you're
it's
getting.
A good presentation.
Yeah, you're gonna get like a second.
New
it's like
shoes,
a new life.
Yeah,
it's a brand new life on your shoes.
Okay, so basically, because a lot of this is just like dust, but so we'll start off with the bottoms.
Okay.
Okay. So what you do? You dip your brush into the solution, and then.
So this is our other co-host Samantha. She likes to, she goes to Coachella from there, and the Stagecoach. And she was talking about how people will go to those with their like brand new white Chucks.
Yeah, people wear expensive shoes there.
And then so they'll come back, and those shoes will kind of look this way.
Done.
Yeah. And you're like, all right, what do I?
So basically, an idea that I really have in mind, which I would love to do. Is I think 3 years ago I wore a pair of Yeezys to Coachella. They're like $700 like resale.
Okay.
So like, and I beat them up obviously because you're going to Coachella.
Yeah.
And when I was there, I was thinking, oh my gosh, I should so have a booth, like a sign there, or even a booth saying like, come to Wype the Hype, or to do it there. Yeah. But the thing is, people are gonna beat them up still.
But people like to spend money at Coachella.
Yeah.
No, but think about that. Imagine you would feel so much.
There, taking them home clean.
You'd feel so much more confident if you had your like if you could know like, oh, I could beat them up Friday night, and then I get them. I don't have to bring multiple pairs.
This is what I always have. Like I went to. Brooklyn music concert, and it was mud everywhere, but I had to put them back in my bag.
So
and so I had to like put them in a bag, and it was like a whole thing. So I just ended up dumping them because they weren't worth it. And if I had gone there, got them cleaned, and put clean shoes back in my bag, I would have saved the shoe.
Yeah.
So now you were saying before, your policy on this though is you drop the shoe off and you're going to take it for 3 days because you want to make sure that it's.
So the thing is that we do have, okay, so this is our menu. So just a real quick thing.
Sure.
So our prices start at $14. They go to $66.
All right.
It really depends on what you get and the different packages you get. The prices range from what materials they are, how dirty they are, and then the packages that you get.
Gotcha.
So, you know, if you want to just get a simple uppers and midsoles, that could start off at $14, and it really can go all the way up there, from there, depending on what you want. Mm-hmm. Every shoe is different.
That's true.
Every
shoe is different. Every shoe takes a different amount of time. Like these. These are a very simple clean. Yeah. So compared to another shoe, this wouldn't be super expensive. Mm-hmm. And I wouldn't recommend anything expensive. But the thing is that people say, like, oh, why is it $38, and it's because like it literally will take an hour to an hour and a half worth of labor.
I have to wonder, how clean is your both car, apartment, dorm room? Are you clean all the time, or is are you living in a mess? What's going on?
I am pretty clean, but the thing is that like I'm so busy that like there'll be times when it's like I'd be like, oh crap, I need to go and clean clean my room. I'm very particular about keeping everything very spotless. Mm-hmm. But you know, sometimes, you know, people get it's a priority, but I it's not like sometimes I'm at the store 15 hours a day. That's
right.
Trusted your own process enough to get your own shoes filled with mud from the back of your store.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And even if I don't get them perfect on the show, believe me, like, these are $400 retail shoes. Like, they're going to look perfect after I'm done with them. It's just, you know, every shoe takes time. Like, I might, after the show, I'll be going back and I'll go over them and clean them really deep.
Has there ever been a time when someone brought in shoes and you were like, nah, bro.
Sorry, man.
There's no way sorry. We can restore these.
So, I can't bring these back.
This was a really funny story. I had a girl and a guy come in about 2 weeks ago. And the girl must have gotten really mad at her boyfriend. Something happened.
Oh, no.
And she took a whole bottle of concealer, like really gross, cheap concealer.
This story makes me
and put it all over it. Like, he had like a very expensive pair of Yeezys.
Oh.
And they were mesh shoes.
They came in together?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so they worked it out.
She paid for it. I think I didn't do it because of the money. I did I did do the shoe.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I didn't do like the shoe because of the money. I did it just to see if I can do it.
Oh,
that's cool.
It took
it's like a little challenge.
It took maybe 5 or 6 hours.
Oh.
It was terrible.
Man.
But
how much did that cost her? I gotta know.
Not even. I charged her $66.
Oh, you should have upped the ante on that.
Even $666
yeah.
on that one. Man, if those were your Yeezys, why did you do it?
Yeah.
What did
we
he
don't
do?
Wanna know what he did. I don't want to know.
Yeah, that's it. I didn't ask. Yeah. I didn't ask, but.
Even shoes have stories.
Actually, I didn't. Basically, we were offering 50% off to any customer that comes in for the first time to be able to get their shoes cleaned.
Uh-huh.
And so she got the $66 package, but got 50% off. So it was $33.
You're killing me.
She probably thought like I'm gonna mess up his whole day.
$33.
And it was only I'm saying like at the end she was like, oh, I feel so horrible. It's gonna cost so much.
Yeah.
And then it was like, oh no, this is $33.
Yeah.
And
But there's only been one other time when I've actually just like I've cleaned the shoes and just I had to say like I'm sorry, like just won't come out. There's a lot of the reason why I like working with like sneakerheads and hypebeasts and these people is because these guys deal with shoes all the time. So like
they know
what can and can't come out, and they've also cleaned their shoes. And so they realize what amount they can get done, and then when they bring it to me and I get like a lot more than what they usually can get out, they're very happy and satisfied. But the problem sometimes is I get people that don't really know about shoes, and they'll come in with like a $80, $60 pair of shoes, and to be able to actually get them perfect, mm-hmm. the cleaning might cost
more.
It might cost like $40 because
yeah.
it's a hard shoe to clean. So there's a lot of times when they come in with like cheaper shoes that I'll tell them honestly, like for you to be completely satisfied, I'd pass on it.
Yeah. That's a fair thing to do.
Yeah. Yes. Let's look at the comparison now because you've done a pretty good job at these shoes. We could see the before and afters right next to each other.
Because this has been what, like maybe 4.5 minutes?
They look brand new again.
Yeah, yeah, like that
I
is.
I mean, these laces are not so clean just because we need to usually wash them under the thing.
So
but like, you know, we can.
That solution is amazing. They're like shiny all over again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's still a lot. I'm still going to be going over them for a while, but they're, you know, there's little things right here, undersoles.
Well, Gio, can we take the surface, my surface?
Yep.
If you want to take a look, if you guys want to follow Wype the Hype on Instagram, it's wypethehype.la, and you can see some of these before and afters, especially
these are my favorites.
Jordans. Here's the before, and then if you swipe over, which would be this little button here, you can see the cleaning job on each of these. So if you're not a believer, which I am because we just saw it in person, we know how dirty your shoes can get. Wype the Hype is on Melrose. Give them the address.
So our address is 7364 Melrose Avenue. So for you sneakerheads or just anyone that in the area, we're a block away from Round 2. We're 3 blocks away from Cool Kicks LA. These are some of the biggest like resale sneaker stores in the world. And these, like, they have shoes going up to like $20,000 sometimes. And it's prime location.
I was going to say, if you're on Melrose, this is the area where you see like lines of kids.
Yeah.
Like just packed
waiting
out.
Waiting for the drop.
Waiting on the street. That, and they're waiting for whatever the newest shoe to come out.
Like, we're right next to probably, I think within like 2 miles, there's probably at least 15 sneaker stores, maybe 20. 20 sneakers.
So a great location.
And then there's
for that.
Supreme right next to the, like
yeah.
within a few blocks, which is a very big clothing brand that's like very hyped for all these people.
Well, I am a believer.
Well, good. Yeah. I'm glad you're here.
He's
look,
off.
I got shoes for days for you. So here you go. These are the Jordans that I just picked up. You can clean those. If you got shoes,
it's
this is the guy right here.
How prepared Scott came for this.
I heard shoes were. I heard shoe cleaning was happening, so I figured why not? Let's do it.
Ellie, thanks so much. Wype the Hype, LA. Make sure you guys go drop off your sneakers, and we will be right back. And hopefully, both of these shoes will be cleaned.
Yeah, and hopefully, I'll put my shoes back on.
Bye bye.